Hello everyone and welcome to Coding Cart. So in this session we will try to understand one hacker rank problem. So you can see the problem name is candies and it's under the greedy section in algorithm. So let me first explain you this problem in a simple way what they are saying. So here we will be given rating of n students. So for example there are 6 students, n equal to 6, and their ratings are suppose 4, 6, 4, 5, 6 and 2. Suppose these are the rating of 6 students. So what we have to do here, we have to distribute candies among these all students, and the criteria is at least one candy should be given to all the student, and second criteria is if two students are sitting next to each other, then the student with the higher rating should get more candies. So you can see here, for example, suppose there are only two students with their rating 4 and 6. So they are saying that at least one candy must be given. So let us give one candy. Now, second criteria is if they are sitting next to each other, then the student with the higher rating should get extra candies. So this student must get extra candies. So we can give either 1, 2, 3, 4 or something. Is higher than this student, but at last we have to return minimum number of candies required for the distribution and satisfying this both condition also at the same time. We have to return minimum number of candies. So we cannot give here 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 or 7. If we can give only one extra candy, so it will become 2 for this student, and for this student the candies will be 1. So this will satisfy this condition 1 and 2, and we can return the minimum candies also. So this is the problem here. So let us go here. So let us assign 1 candies to all the student. Now let us iterate 1 by 1. Now for this student the candies is 1. Now let us move forward. Now you can see here the rating is higher for this student. We are only comparing these two students. So out of these two students, the rating is over higher. So we will give one extra candy to satisfy these both conditions. So candies for this student will become 2. Now let us move forward. Now for this student, the candy is 1, but the rating is also low. So no need to give extra candies. Let us move forward. Now for this student you can see the rating is higher from this previous student. So what we will do, we will increase the candies. Let us increase by 1. Now let us move forward. Now you can see here the rating is higher for this student, so we will increase the candies with 1. So by increasing the candies with 1, so you can see here both the students are having equal number of candies, but the rating for this student is higher, so we have to increase the candies again by 1. Now let us move forward. Now rating for this student is lower, so no need to give extra candies. So we are done. At last we have to return this total number of candies, so which will become 1, 3, 4, 6, 9 and 10. So total we have to return the total number of minimum as 10. So this is the problem here. We have to complete this function candies, in which they are giving the total number of student and the rating array. So here the approach is quite simple. Let me take few scenario here. For example, the very first scenario is suppose there are 5 student and their rating are in increasing order. Very first scenario, suppose the rating are in increasing order 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now let us assign one candies, at least one candies to all the student. Now we will start from the second one, and the condition over here is we will check if my current rating is greater than the previous rating. This is my current, this is my previous. If this condition is satisfied, so what we will do for the current candies, we'll simply add one to from the previous candies. Previous candies plus one. Since we have to replace the current candies with the previous candies plus one. So you can see here. Their current rating is greater than the previous one. So what we will do, we will simply replace this with the previous candies plus 1, which will become 2. Now let us move forward. So you can see here again, the current rating is greater than the previous one. So what we will do here, we have to replace the value with previous candies plus 1. So previous candies is 2 plus 1, it will become 3. Let us move forward. Again here the current rating is higher than the previous one. So let us update the candies value. The previous candies plus 1, which will become 3 plus 1, 4. Now let us move forward. Again here the current rating is higher than the previous one. So what we will do here, we will update the candies with previous candies plus 1, which will become 5. Now we are done. At last we will simply sum up this value. This will become 15. So this logic will work. Now let us take the second scenario where n equal to 5 means 5 student and all the ratings are in decreasing order. So we'll take this same example but in decreasing order. Suppose 5, 4, 3, 2 and 1. Now for this type of scenario in decreasing order, we'll move from backward. So suppose we are here, we'll start from the second last element and check the previous element. We'll apply the same logic over here, the same logic. So you can see here, we'll apply the same logic. Current rating, if it is greater than the previous rating, then what we will do, we will update my current candies with the previous candies plus 1. So you can see here that the current rating is higher than the previous one. So initially it is having candies 1, so value will be updated with previous plus 1, it will become 2. Now we will move to this element. Again this rating is higher, so candies will become previous plus 1, which will become 3. Just move forward. Again here the rating is higher, so candies will be previous candies plus 1, which will become 3 plus 1, which will be 4. Again we move forward. Again here rating is higher, so previous candies plus 1, again it will become 5, and we have to return this as our answer. So 15. So this condition will work. Now let us take another scenario. Scenario 3, in which suppose n equal to 5 students whose ratings are constant 3, 3, 3, 3. Now you can see here, initially we are assigning at least one candies to all the students. Now if we are applying this logic, the very first one, let us check. We are here and it is checking whether this current value, current rating is greater than the previous one. No, it is not greater. Let us move forward. Again it is not greater than the previous one. Let us move forward. Again not greater. Let us move forward. Now we are done with the very first iteration. While moving forward we are done, means our answer will be 5. Now let us check from the backward. We have applied this forward. This was my forward movement checking, and this is backward. Now, while checking from the backward, you can see again here. We are here and it is checking whether this value is greater than the previous one. No, it is not greater. Let us move forward. Again, this value is not greater. Let us move forward. Again, not greater. Let us move forward. Means this forward movement and backward movement condition will handle this case also. Again, this will return in 5. So this case is handled in this condition. Now, the fourth one, in which the ratings are in mixed form. Suppose n equal to, let us take n equal to 10 student, and it is mixed type. Rating is in mixed form. Suppose the ratings values are 2, 4, 2, 6, 1, 2, 8, 9, 2 and 1. Suppose these are the ratings in mixed form. Now, while moving forward, we'll start from here and we'll check the current value is greater than the previous one. Yes, it is greater. So what we will do? Suppose the candy over here was 1. So its value will be previous value plus 1. It will become 2. Now let us move forward. Here the value is not greater. So by default 1 candies will be here. 1 candies by default is given to all the student. Now we are moving forward. Now you can see here rating is greater. So what we will do? Will increase 1 with the previous value. Previous is 1 plus 1 2. Let us move forward. Again it is less, no need to increase. Again here the rating is greater, so let us increase by 1 plus 1 2. Again here the rating is greater, so we'll increase previous plus 1, which will become 3. Now let us move forward. Now you can see here again the rating is greater than previous plus 1, so it will become 4. Let us move forward. Now here the rating is low, so it will remain 1. Let us move forward. Now you can see here again it is low, so no need to increase the candies. Now have a look over here in this section. If these two students are sitting next to each other, here the student is having rating 2 and this student is having rating 1, but here the candies are equal, but the candies for this student must be higher, means he must get extra candies. So this was my forward movement. Forward movement, we got this as our answer. This as our answer for forward movement. Now let us move backward. So we'll start from the second one. So let us start from here. So this is our current rating. So previously we were checking whether my current rating is greater than the previous rating. So you can see here my current rating is 2 and previous rating is, this is my previous. So previous rating is 1. Yes, if this case was satisfied previously, so we were adding 1 in my current candies. So current candies was equal to previous candies plus 1. So my current candies will be changed to, this will be changed to previous plus 1, which will become 2 now. Now let us move forward. Now you can see here my current rating is how much? 9. Now 9 greater than the previous one. Yes, previous is 2. Yes, this case is satisfied. So if it is satisfied, then we are changing the value of current candies equal to previous candies plus 1. So my this value will be changed to previous candies 2 plus 1, which will become 3 now. So this value is getting changed to 3. So you can see here this value is being affected. Initially, when we were moving forward in forward direction, here my rating is 8 and its rating was 9. So it was in increasing order. So we have added 1 in our previous value. But while coming in backward direction, it again got decreased to 1, means 1 less. By adding 1 in my previous value, the value got increased from backward, but after checking the previous value, means while coming from forward, the value got decreased to 1, means this logic is not working in backward direction. If we are getting the input in mixed form, then while coming in backward direction, this logic is not working. So what we will do, we will add one more condition over here. So let us write one more condition over here. Let us add one condition. If the current rate is greater than the previous rate, then at the same time we will add one condition. We will check whether my current candies is less than equal to the previous candies. If this is the case, then only we will update our current candies. Now you can see here, my current rate is 2, which is greater than the previous one, and again we are checking whether my current candies, which is 1, which is equal to the previous candies 1. Yes, this equal to case is satisfied. So what we will do, we will update our current candies by previous plus 1, so it will become 2. Now let us move forward. Now you can see here, current rating is 9 is greater than the previous one, which is 2. So this case is satisfied. Now the second is current candy is how much? 4. Whether 4 less than equal to the previous candy, previous is 2. So this case is not satisfied, so we cannot update our current candy's value, means it is okay. So you can see here, it is okay, means if you see here, for these 3 elements, for these 2, the rating for this student is high, so its candies is also high. More, if you are considering only these 2 student, so you can see a rating is high for this student and candies is also high for this student only, so this logic is working. Now let us move forward. You can see a rating is low, so this case is false. Simply move forward, again low, again low, again low. Here the rating is high, so the rating is high. Here we will check the current candy's value is less than equal to the previous one, which is again false. Let us move forward. Rating is low, let us move forward. Now rating is high. Now we will check the current candy's is less than equal to the previous one, it is false. Let us move forward. Here the rating is low, so the very first case is only false. So we are done. So we got the answer. So we are done. Our forward formula is also working and backward formula is also working. So this formula will work and the forward formula will work, this one. So our answer will be 3, 4, 6, 7, 9, 12, 16, 18 and 19. So our answer is 19. So we'll return 19 as our answer. So let us write the logic. So the very first thing is, we will take one result array. So result equal to list type, in which all the value will be initialized with 1. And its length will be of length of the array size, length of n. Now we'll apply the logic for the forward movement. Forward movement, which is for I in range, we'll start from the second element to the last. length of array, and we will check. Now we will apply the logic here. We are standing at the second element, so we will check with the previous one. Now if array of I greater than the array of I minus 1, means the current value checking with the previous one. If it is greater, then what we have to do here? We have to update our result of the current. This is Candy's, so current Candy's value will be updated with previous one, previous Candy's plus 1. So this was our forward movement logic. So we have applied the same over here. Now let us apply for the second backward movement. Now let us write the logic for the backward. So for I in range, we will start from the last index. So length of array minus 1, and we have to traverse till the first element in reverse order. Now we will check if, let me explain you here again. Suppose there are 5 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So your length is 5, but the index are 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. My index is here 4, so I have to start from length minus 1. So currently my I is here. So what we will do, we will move forward by I minus 1, array of I minus 1 as my current rate, and my previous rate will be array of I. So I am checking if my current in this rating is greater than my previous rating. If it is greater, then I will, at the same time, I will be checking one more condition. I will be checking result of my current value is less than equal to the result of, means total candies of my previous value, which is I. At the same time, means this condition and this condition, this array of I minus 1, this is I minus 1, I will be treating this value as my current value and I as my previous value. So let us write the logic over here. So if array of I minus 1 is the current value is greater than the array of I, means previous value. If it is satisfying the condition, then at the same time we will apply one more logic, which is the candy's value, current candy's value I minus 1, if it is less than equal to current value, current candy's value, if it is less than equal to the previous value array of I, then only we will update our current values, current candy's, which is result of I minus 1 will be result of I, means previous, plus 1, means here I minus 1 is treated as the current and I is treated as the previous one. Here I is treated as my previous and I minus 1 is treated as the current. You can see here. Now at the last we have to return our answer. Return sum of the result. So we are done. Now let us run this code. So we are getting runtime error. Inject type int. Okay. So here we have to give not n but length of array. Let us run this code. So you can see here it is working fine. Let us submit this code. So we are done with all the hidden. So congratulations, we are done with all the hidden test cases. So this was the logic here in which we have to do one forward movement checking and another was the backward movement checking with one extra condition over here. So if you like this video, please do give thumbs up and subscribe to our channel Coding Cart and stay tuned for the next video. Thanks for watching.